Hi everyone, this is Martin Baraya, and today we will be learning about Android Jetpack navigation. So first of all, what is the Jetpack navigation? The Jetpack navigation is used for navigating around the app, like moving from one screen to another, and it is a fundamental part of Android development. And it is used to do something more complex than clicking a button, like bottom navigation. So to understand more how the Jetpack navigation works, there is a three major part of navigation component working together: the navigation graph, a nav host fragment, and nav controller. So let's get started to building Android Jetpack navigation in Android Studio. And depend on the Android documentation notes, if you want to use navigation with Android Studio, you must use Android Studio version 3.3 or higher. Okay, let's start from scratch. So we're gonna start a new project with empty activity. We're gonna name it Jetpack or whatever you want, and you can choose the location for it. Actually, I have empty folder named Jetpack on the desktop, and we can start with Kotlin, and then we can choose the minimum API level. After done, just hit finish. And the Gradle should be take some time to build. Gradle build finished. So first of all, we need a fragment. I can choose the fragment with a view model. We can name it main fragment. With Kotlin, and just hit finish. So after that, we need two more fragments. So we're gonna choose fragment plane. I'm gonna name it first fragment. Make sure to uncheck these two boxes. Just hit finish. And we're gonna do the same thing for the second fragment. Like second finish. And actually, we're gonna work with the main fragment and main activity, and first fragment and second fragment. And we don't gonna use the main view model. Okay, now let's working with the Gradle dependency. So in the dependency, we're gonna add these two lines of code. with the now version. I'm gonna choose sync now. Okay. Then we're gonna choose the Gradle top level and inside the all projects. So we're gonna add this line of code, Android support version, to support version 28. Just choose sync now. So now we're gonna create a navigation graph. Just close this windows. Okay. So inside the resource and layouts, inside the main activity XML file, we're gonna work in the graph. Now first of all, we're gonna delete the text view because we don't need it, and we're gonna add our layouts. This one, I'm gonna choose match balance. And we can add the ID for it. And name it container. Okay, now we can add tag fragment inside our layout. Just hit Alt Enter. So we add the ID and we add the Android name because this is nav host fragment for hosting the fragment, and we can do the width and height with 0 dB and this position for constraint layout. So that's it for this one right now, and then we will create nav graph navigation inside the resource folder. So we can choose new Android resource file and make sure to choose the resource type navigation, and we can name it nav graph. Press OK. And then let's go to the design part, and from this tab we can choose the main fragment like this one. Then we're gonna return back to the main activity, and inside the fragment we're gonna add this two line of code. For default nav host equal true, and navigraph, this is the path, this is the navigraph we made it inside the navigation and navigraph. Okay, and now we need to switch to the main activity, the main activity. We need a drawer layout, so we're gonna create a variable for drawer layout. After that, on the onCreate method, we need a variable for find fragment by ID. So we're gonna make it val with name host equal to support fragment manager, find the fragment by ID, and this is the ID name. And casting for nav host fragment can accept the node. Then we will create nav controller from the host. Nav controller from the host that controlling the navigation bar. On the drawer layout, we need to connect it with the ID. This is drawer layout connected with the, this ID container, this one. Now we will link nav controller with the drawer by using navigation UI with action bar, setup action bar navigation controller. This refer to the activity. Add nav controller for this variable and drawer for this variable. After that, we gonna create override method by pressing Ctrl O. Name it on support navigation app, this one, and we choose this method that refer to what happened if the user press the back button. Then change the return value to be navigation UI, navigation app, drawer, this is drawer, and handle the ID for the activity, for the main fragment. Okay, now let's switch to the nav graph navigation. And we're gonna add two more fragments. First fragment and second. This first fragment. And the second fragment. So we can just made the graphic one of graph. We can connect by using this nice action. The great thing about this, we can connect it from one fragment to another by using this ID, this action ID. By using this action ID, we can connect it from one fragment to another. Okay, now let's switch to the design part inside the main fragment. Just add two buttons this two color. And these two buttons used to connect between two fragments. So now let's switch to the main fragment. Inside the main fragment, we're gonna overwrite the other method called onViewCreate method. And this method used to connect between fragments. And then we can use setOnClickListener to connect button with the fragment. Like this. We just use FindView by ID with the ID of the button. And the navigation with the action ID for the navigation here. This one. And this ID. And we can do same thing for the second button. We just need to change this to bum 2, this action to be action main fragment to second fragment. And that's it. Actually, we're almost done. Just the last thing we're gonna go through, the nav graph, and we're gonna change the label for the main fragment to be home or anything you want. And the first fragment and second fragment, we're gonna change the text. First fragment, you can change the text to anything you want. You can make it like first and second fragment. I'm gonna change the text to be second on the set. Plus I can add some design to the first and second fragment. For the first fragment, can add some design for it to be like this. And for second fragment too, I just add the text size with the text style with the color with this stuff to be like this. And that's it. Okay guys, now we will test it by using Android Studio emulator. So this is the first fragment. When you choose the first fragment, it goes to the first back button, it goes, and the second fragment, choose the second. That's it. And thank you for watching.